Hello everyone, I am Sapna Balara. I welcome you all in the next topic of our writing, that is diary entry. First of all, I will explain what is a diary entry. A diary entry is the writing down of events, transaction or observation in a highly personalized manner. Means you have to explain your own feeling in your diary. Like maybe some of you are writing the diary. Some of you don't have the habit of writing any diary. So diary entry means you are sharing your feeling in your diary. It is wrapped around creative thoughts and is basically the outpouring of what one feels and has experienced with regard to a particular stimuli. A diary entry can be written on a daily basis also or at intervals, depending on the inclination of the writer. So you can also write down daily diary entry or a particular interval also. But some points you have to remember when you are writing diary entry. First, it should be written in chronological order, means the date of happening the things, and that happening of the things according to that time you have to write down your events. In diary entry, day, date, place, time of the event of the entry should be written. A suitable descriptive heading or subpoints, some points about hints about the topic written about may be included. Here, next, the main body of the diary entry should be written in a comprehensive manner, giving a precise yet complete description of an event, a place or a person. In diary entry, you can include all the three parts that we have already discussed. On all the three parts, we can write down the diary entry. It should express the writer's point of view, lay stress on feeling, emotions rather than the event itself. Means you can have to give emphasis on the feeling and emotions of the writer. You have to express your views in your diary entry. It should be personalized, means you have to share your experience there. Written in first person because you are writing the diary entry, and maybe in the past tense. Most of the diary entry you have to write down in past tense only. The writing should be informal. You are writing your own things in the diary entry. So writing should be informal writing, not in a formal way. You are not writing to any manager or any other specific person. So you are writing your feelings, so it must be informal writing. Next, you can write down your name or signature at the end. These points you have to remember when you are writing a diary entry. Now I am telling the format of diary entry. It is very easy. The format is very easy. First of all, in format, you must write down the day. Day means don't write down this word day or date or time. Specifically, you have to write down like today is Thursday. You can write down Thursday here. Date. You can write down the date like 20 May 2020. Don't use the word day and date in your diary. Directly you can write down the name of the day. Directly you can write down the date. But date should be incomplete. As already I told you, in writing you must write down the complete month name. No short form, no number you have to use for month name. Time. Approx time you can write down. It is not necessary you must have the watch with you. An exact time you have to write down. Approx time you can write down at the last of the line. Like AM, PM, with AM, PM you can write down. Like 10:30 PM, 10:30 AM, anything you can write down. In the next line, without leaving any line, you have to write down the place. You can write down Sisyamu School. When you are writing in your exams, you can write down examination hall, Shri Dungargarh. So place name you can write down Shri Dungargarh also. In exams you can write down examination hall also. Okay. Then leave. Here you have to leave one line blank. then dear diary, you have to write down these words, dear diary. Then again leave one line blank. Here you have to give the title or the hint you can give here. In next line, leave one line here again. Here also you have to leave one line blank. Then in introduction, don't give any subheading in your explanation part. No need to give any subheading in diary entry. I have written this one because for your reference, you have to write down you have to introduce here your topics in two line, three line. You have to give introduction of the topic, a small description of the topic. Then leave one line blank. Then you have to give the details. Again, I'm telling, don't write down any subheading in diary entry. Directly, you can start your paragraph. But your paragraph must be 2-3 paragraph you have to write down in diary entry. Not in a single paragraph you have written each and everything. In the second paragraph, you can give the details of the event, place or any event, person. Then leave one line blank. At last, you have to share your feelings. You felt very happy, you felt very sad, how you enjoyed, what do you want to convey, if you want to convey any message, that also you can write down. So at last you have to give your feelings, then leave one line blank and your name. Clear? Now in this way you have to write down your diary entry. It is very simple, only you have to take care of the format of date, time and place. Then dear entry, title, next is depend on you. I hope so you have understand diary entry. I will give you some question to write it down in your register also. First of all, you have to write down the format. Thank you.